Distinguished invited guests, ladies and gentlemen. I just wish to thank ICTP for inviting Zambia to this wonderful celebration, ICTP after full 45 years. Zambia congratulates ICTP for the services it has been offering to the international community in science education and research and development. Zambia takes this opportunity to participate in this conference as a platform for interaction with the center and also with other participants in the promotion of science education in developing countries and less developed countries like Zambia. In the past, Zambia has not actively participated in the center's activities, and we hope that this will now come to a change. Zambia as a country has a mandate to develop national scientific and technological capacities and provide highly skilled human resource for the improvement of the country's economy productivity and also eradication of poverty. The country has been integrating science, technology, and innovation in its socio-economic development in the wake of fast-moving world into knowledge economy and innovation economies. Zambia, as a country, has been investing slowly in the human resource development and also investing in infrastructure development for science and technology. This hasn't been easy. To just say some of the programs, Zambia has established centers like the National Science Center, which is upgrading the science and mathematics teaching for local production of science equipment in the country. That addresses problem of classroom laboratory equipment. Zambia also has established some kind of funds, which is providing some funds for research and development, some scholarships to female students at postgraduate level, and also in terms of infrastructure development and rehabilitation of some infrastructure. Zambia also, with the assistance of the Japanese, has been strengthening the science, mathematics, and technological education for professions, that is teachers in high school and upper basic schools in the various parts of the country to improve the quality of teaching and learning activities for science teachers in schools. Zambia has faced quite a lot of challenges in its effort to strengthen the science education. I'll just mention a few. There's been inadequate human resources that are throughout the education system, and for us, we are starting from the lower levels up to the university levels. This creates a problem in science making an impact in the programs of the country. There is also inadequate financing in the science and technology innovation development, and this really falls below international and also the region standards. Due to poor conditions of staff that are in the science, technology, and innovation, this has contributed to brain drain. A lot of Zambian scientists are leaving the country for better opportunities and in other countries within the region and also far away countries. As a least developed countries, we also experience high attrition rates due to HIV, and this threatens the sustainability of programs in the country. Even if we are trying to develop the human resource capacity, but you find a lot of people are dying. In terms of science curriculum, this is also falls far from being adequate, and this creates a lot of problems because what we observe is that most of the learning is through theory, and it lacks the practical demonstration. There's also insufficient collaboration with industry, and what we find in the country, there's little investment from the private sector. So the future, we see ICTP playing a role in our country and also other cooperating partners in promoting science, mathematics, and technical subjects for early learners so that we could have a pool of people who then can be developed into scientists. We also see the center and other supporting agencies helping the country in terms of developing human resources in the different fields of sciences. In conclusion, what we're saying, as it was identified, for the least developed countries, there may be a different model needed in their development compared to the other models that have been used for the developed and developing world, because the challenges that we are facing. Because the challenges that we are facing are of different dimension and magnitude. Thank you very much.